Hello everyone, this is Rajiv and welcome back. And today in this tutorial we are going to create this monkey on meditation animation using PowerPoint 2016. So let's get started. So before we dig into the tutorial, let me show you the objects that I have used to create this monkey here and with the background. So if you open the selection pane from the home tab, go to the home tab, click the select drop down button and choose selection pane. Then you can see all the objects that I have drawn using the shape tool. Under the insert menu, if you go to the shapes, then you can find all the ready-made shapes, and mostly I use freeform, rectangle, rounded corner rectangle, these kinds of shape. And if you want more information about using shape tools, then you can watch my playlist. The link of that playlist is given in the description below. So this animation is basically inspired from one of the animation at dribble.com by Formers Studio. So here is the original animation. I skipped this wave animation for now. Maybe I will cover it in the next tutorial. So let's see the animations that I have used in this presentation. Before doing these kinds of animation, you must know that which objects should be separated from the entire character. So if I open the animations pane by going to animations tab and then click animation pane. So here you can see the list of the animations that I have used in this presentation. And if you look carefully, then you will find that most of the objects have the same animation, the motion paths. These three types of motion path has been applied to almost all the objects that are moving in this presentation. So here you can see the object list and you can see that which objects are separated from the entire scene. So here we have this right arm, left arm, right ear, left ear, and then right leg and left leg, and then the clothes and the body of the monkey. So here is the body. So if I can separate them, then you can see that how I have drawn all these shapes here. These are the ears. So these two objects has been used to cover the eyes, as you can see here, right eye cover and left eye cover. So we will begin with the right leg, and I will show you how to animate the right leg, and then we will use the animation painter to apply the same animation to almost all the rest of the objects. So let's talk about the effect that I have used in this presentation. So as you can see on left leg, I have applied the spin animation. And if you want more information about how to apply effects, then you should watch my video on Introduction to PowerPoint 2016. And the link of that video is in the cards. So here I have applied the spin animation with 3-degree counterclockwise rotation, with auto reverse, without any smoothness. In the timing tab, you can see that the duration of this animation is 0.75 seconds and I am repeating this animation 3 times. So if I show you the animation, let me mute the audio first. Go to the playback, click the volume icon and then choose mute. Do this for this as well. And let me show you the animation. So as you can see that the leg move up, then start spinning. Then after 3 spins, it fall down. So to move the leg up, we have used the up animation, up motion path. Then we used again the down motion path with auto reverse, with smoothness, and we are repeating this effect 3 times. And finally, the leg moved down to its original location. And for that, we have used a separate animation of down. If we see the animation of the right leg, then you can see that the spin animation has been changed to clockwise from counterclockwise, and the rest of the animation settings are the same, and the same motion path has been applied to the right leg, clothes, body, face, left ear, right ear. Even on the ears, we have also applied the spin animation. As you can see, 3-degree clockwise, auto reverse, repeating for 2 times, and duration is 0.15 seconds. And these animations have a little bit delay between the animations. So if you look at the left leg, then you can see that duration is 1 second, delay is 0. The second animation is duration 0.75 with delay 1 second. And third animation is at point duration is 0.25 second with the delay timing over 5.50 seconds. So if I move down and show you the animation of right arm, then you can notice that there are not much difference between the duration and the delay timing. Almost all the objects are moving at the same speed beside the clothes. If I show you the cloth animation right here, then you can notice a difference between the second motion path of this cloth, where it is 1.15. For rest of the object, it will be 1 second. So that is the only difference. So I will show you that how I have applied all these motion paths. That is the most important point in this tutorial. And we will also talk about the tools, motion path tools that we have talked about in our previous tutorial. So I will tell you about the align or join option of this add-in in PowerPoint 2016. So let's get started with the right leg. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to copy this leg, insert a new slide, change the layout of this slide to blank, close these all pen. And as you can see that I have drawn a lot of guides in the previous presentation, and I will tell you why. You can use the guides feature from the view menu, click the guides, and if you want more information about how to use guides, then you can watch my tutorial on, that is the Microsoft Word tutorial on using guides and grid lines, and the link of that video is also in the cards. So here I'm going to paste that right leg. So here we have that leg, and if I go to the animation span, then you can see all the animation that I have applied on this object here. So if I zoom in, then you can see that those motion path, first it move up, then it moved down and up for 3 times, and finally it dropped down at the original location with the third motion path. So how you can apply these 3 kinds of motion path on a single object? That is the main thing that you need to learn here. And along with this, we will also use the align or join motion path tool. So here I will go to the animation span, select the object and click add effect, more motion paths. And here I am going to apply the up motion path. Hit the OK key and adjust the length of the path. And if you have guides enabled, then you can drag this guide on the top of the motion path. So if you will now align the motion path, then it will try to adjust itself with the guides. So that is the benefit of using guides along with motion paths. So again, I am going to apply another motion path, and what I want, the starting position of the next motion path should be at the end position of the first motion path. So if I again choose the motion path and choose down motion path, and you should always use down when you need to apply a second motion path, and let me tell you why. Because that way you can easily adjust the starting and ending position of the second motion path. Like the starting point of the second motion path is this, and I want the starting point to be at the ending point of the first motion path. So I hold it right from here, the green dot, hold down the shift key, and then just drag it on the top, and you will feel a magnet right here if you have enabled the guides. And I will drag this motion path a little bit below, maybe right here. Okay, that's fine. So I am going to adjust both of these to play with previous, with a short duration, delay timing 1 second for the second, and duration 0.50, let's say. Now again, I am going to apply the third motion path. And for that, I will select this object again, add motion path, and again I will select the down motion path, and this time the starting position will be right here, and the ending position will be at the bottom. Set it to play with previous, delay timing 1.50 and a very short duration of 0.25 seconds. And I would also like to repeat this animation 3 times with auto reverse, and let me add the delay timing to this animation Let's see the preview again. So that's fine. So that is how I applied the motion path animation to the first right leg object. So then what I did, let's say I have this second object right here. Send it to back. So let me delete all these animations. So then what I did, I selected this right leg, go to the animation span, click on the animation painter, and then click on the second object that you want to move. So that way I applied the same motion path to almost all the objects by using the animation painter. So if you are making this animation by yourself, then the motion to path tools can be really helpful to you. Let me show you the second option of this tool, align or join. So what it can do for you. So when you are aligning the motion paths to an object, especially if you are applying various motion paths to a lot of objects, then you can see the rush of the animations and their signs on the object. So here we are going to use align or join option of the motion path. So let's say I increase the length of this motion path. So when you are adjusting motion path over the motion path, then sometimes the motion path does not align properly. So let's say there is a difference between this motion path, and let me show you the preview. So you can see the skip in the right leg. So what I can do right now, let me delete this object. We don't need this. So what I can do now, I can go to the align or join and select all these three motion paths and hit the OK key, and you will see that it will automatically adjust the length of the motion path according to the ending points. So if I show the slideshow, so you can see that the skip has been removed automatically and the motion path length has been set properly automatically by align or join option. So that is what it can do. The second thing that it can do is it can consolidate the different path to a single path. So if I go to the animation, add animation, motion path, let's say I apply the left motion path, and again I apply the up motion path to the same object. Okay, where is up? And then adjust the position of the east path like this, and finally one more time I am going to apply the left motion path, and this time I am going to start it from right here and will end it right here. So we have these three motion paths. So what I want, so let me show you the preview. So if you go to the tools, align or join, and select all these three motion paths, and then make a check mark on generate new consolidated motion path animation from selected items and hit the OK key, then you can find a new animation right at the bottom of the all the animations. So if I delete these three previous animations, then the new animation has a single consolidated motion path. Let me show you the preview. So that is what this tool can do. So that is how I used motion path in this presentation. Let me tell you one more thing in this presentation about the third eye. So if you look at the third eye animation, which will get visible after 3 seconds. So here we have two more objects for the third eye, and these are the right eye cover and the left eye cover, and they are also moving along with the other objects, but get only visible when we need the third eye to get open. So if you see here, then you can notice that the left eye cover has the same motion path because the covers are also moving along with the body. So after that, there happens the wipe effect. If I show you the effect here, you can see that I have applied the wipe effect to the covers, and for one cover it is the left wipe, and for the second cover is the right wipe. In the end, to hide the third eye again, I used the entrance wipe effect, and for removing the cover, we were using exit wipe effect. And to cover them again, we are using entrance wipe effect with the same from right and from left options right here. So that is how I created this monkey on meditation animation in PowerPoint 2016, and I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for giving your time, and have a wonderful day.